Here's how you can make any song longer or shorter using Adobe Audition. Hello everyone, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can make a song longer or shorter in Audition, you can too. Sometimes when you're editing a video, you find a song that you like, and it's just a bit short for the video. With Adobe Audition's remixing feature, you can make a song longer or shorter using Audition's remix. Now, let's head inside Adobe Audition. If you don't have Adobe Audition, I'll put an affiliate free trial link in the description down below. Now, one thing you'll need is a song to remix, and I'll also put some free affiliate links to Artlist and Epidemicsound, plus the completely free YouTube audio library, so you can find a song to follow along with me. I chose the song you're hearing now in the background from Artlist, and it's the remixed version. To remix a song, you need to create a multi-track session in Adobe Audition by clicking on multi-track in the top left-hand corner. You can drag and drop your audio into an Audition multi-track session to import it. Or you can click on File, Import, and find the file you want to bring into Audition. Once your audio track is in the project, we're going to make our way to the Properties panel here. One thing to be careful of when remixing in this way is to make sure that the song you're licensing allows you to remix it. Both of the affiliated websites I linked in the description down below allow this, but always be sure to read the fine print. In the Properties panel, we'll go ahead and find Remix. I'm going to click on it to expand the Remix tab, and then I'll select Enable Remix. Adobe Audition will then analyze your audio to find the best natural transition points within the audio. I'll be sure to link an Adobe article that goes more in depth on how this is done in the video description down below. However, our audio is done being analyzed, and we can now enter how long we'd like our song to be here in the target duration section. Now, an obvious answer is the duration of your video. So you can type in your video's length here. When the track is remixed, you can see on the multi-track timeline where the edits of the remix are with these squiggly lines here. You might be like me and wondering, how is this possible? Adobe says that Remix uses a combination of beat detection, content analysis, and spectral source separation technology to identify hundreds of transition points in your song. It then rearranges the passages to create a composition. This technology is incredible and has even more options for customization. In fact, let's look at those in the advanced section. Stretch to the exact duration. It's clear in the name what it does. It will make sure that it matches the exact duration you put in the target duration. Now, edit length will help you make the track shorter or longer with this slider here. Shorter, for example, will make the song, well, shorter. But if I make it shorter, look at the amount of cuts on the timeline here. On the other hand, if we make it longer, it's looking for the smallest amount of transition. Both have use cases, and I recommend experimenting with what sounds best to you. Then in features, you can choose to have more timber. This means the tonal quality and helps for that in transition. On the other hand, there's harmonic, which focuses more on the melodic and harmonic parts during transition. The final two options are minimum loop and maximum slack. With the minimum loop, you can set the minimum acceptable length in beats to use in a segment. With maximum slack, you can set the maximum difference in duration from your target duration. The choices are up to you as the creative. You also can listen to the remix. And if you don't like how it sounds, you can change it by reverting the remix. To revert a remix clip, right-click on the clip and then find Remix, expand it, and select Revert Remix. From there, you can remix the track again, maybe using more of the advanced features to make it sound exactly how you like. However, if you're happy with your remix, all you need to do is export the file. To do so, click on File and then make your way to Export. From here, I usually name my file Remix and then the original song name. From there, I'll decide if I want to use MP3 or the WAV format for my audio. This is honestly going to depend on your specific project needs, so make sure that it's fitting what your needs are. From there, I'm going to go ahead and click Export. All you have to do is add the song back into your editing program of choice. For me, it's usually Premiere Pro or Premiere Rush. Once you do that, the song is good to go. If you want to make changes, you can edit the original file again, or edit the remix, and then make changes to your heart's content. Remixing music gives you more options for your music and songs within a project. If you want to have some fun, try remixing a song with vocals. It can be an interesting experience. But I want to know, where do you get your music for YouTube? Please let me know in those comments down below. And do you want to learn more about Artlist? One of the places I got the music for this video? Then check out that video on screen. Now, let's go out there and have more control of our music. And it's important to remember, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can, you can too.